Used car prices are spiking. Hello, I'm Kevin Hunter, the Homework Guy, here with the amazing Elizabeth. And I mentioned this last time, Liz, but I want our viewers to know that not only did I not ask Liz to cover for me while I was gone, I couldn't, and neither did anybody here at the Homework Guy team. She just stepped in and did it. That's what true leadership is all about. So thanks, Liz, for that, and great job.
Oh, thanks, Kevin.
All right, let's take a look back to June this past year. The average purchase price of a new car was $42,000, according to Kelly.
And used car prices had reached a record $25,000 while having an average of 68,000 miles on them. In total, U.S. car production fell 23% in 2020, and it's down another 8% in 2021.
Shortages of new vehicles have been the biggest driver of high used car prices. The car market loses vehicles all the time for other reasons as well, including a combination of life cycle, accidents, and natural disasters. There was also a mass exodus of people who lived in the city and used public transportation who moved to more rural locations, driving the need for more vehicles. GM and Ford are already saying that they expect the chip shortage to have an impact into 2023.
Most recently at Mannheim, the largest used auto auction, used car prices increased 3.1% in the first 15 days of December, a 48.9% increase over December 2020. And Black Book, which is used by car dealers, showed a 45% increase for car prices in November 2021 versus the previous year. This much of an increase should be a red flag to anyone, which is why here at the Homework Guy, we are simply waiting for the car price bubble to burst.
Namely, that's going to happen soon.
For sure. When people who bought this past year or so go to trade in their vehicles in 2 to 5 years, they're not going to get the extra overpriced value for their trade. They'll be taking a loss. As soon as everything in the car pipeline gets fixed, it's game over on high prices.
There are two big reasons that the prices are still high. We've got high consumer demand right now and low supply. Cox Automotive predicts that wholesale prices will remain or even continue to climb while car dealers get ready for the spring selling season, which historically is a high volume time for car sales. Regardless of inventory, 2021 was a record-setting year for car profits again.
And in case you're wondering, there are about 958,000 new vehicles in inventory right now. That's 1.7 million fewer than last year and 2.5 million fewer than 2019. And 350 dealerships have sold and changed hands this year alone, up from 289 in 2020. And you know who's selling, right? It's the little guys. The big automotive groups just keep getting bigger and bigger.
Speaking of getting bigger, CarMax is having no trouble keeping its lots full. During the third quarter last year, they purchased over 383,000 vehicles, and 194,000 of those were purchased from customers using the instant online appraisal tool. CarMax is the largest buyer of used vehicles from consumers and largest used vehicle retailer. And guess what? They made more revenue and net earnings too.
Surprise. So what's going to cause this bubble to burst? Rising interest rates. The Fed just announced that they're deploying the highly unpopular tactic of increasing interest rates to help control inflation.
Much to the chagrin of car dealers.
Like everybody.
All right, if you appreciate our video today, consider giving us a big thumbs up, and please always remember to comment on our videos and share them with family and friends. Comments really matter because they help boost our online visibility and lead others to great Homework Guy content.
The entire Homework Guy team is here to represent you, the car buyer, and that's what we love to do.
Thanks everyone for coming back. We'll see you on our next video. You guys rock. I'm Kevin Hunter with the amazing Elizabeth.
We gotta go.